Hey there, my name is Leon, and in this video I will show you how to create a modern professional cover letter template in Word. Before we start, please subscribe to support the channel. At first we have to set the correct page format, so we go to the Layout tab, click on Size and select the size that we need. Since in my country the A4 format is standard, I will choose A4 here. Then we will insert a horizontal bar which will contain our contact information. So we open the Insert tab, then the Shapes dropdown and select the rectangular shape. Now we just roughly drag the rectangle and then we set the exact size for the rectangle. I'm going to set 1 cm for the height and 21 cm for the width. Note that I'm choosing a width that is the exact size of my page. So if you chose the letter format for example, you should set a width of 21.59 cm. Then we center this bar by clicking on Align and afterwards on Align Middle. And now we change the color of the bar. Since I don't want to use any of the predefined colors, I click on More Fill Colors and set a custom color here. Let's now insert our first contact icon. We again go to Insert and select Icons. Then we type phone in the search bar and select the corresponding icon. For this icon, we have to change the layout option so that we can freely move it on the page. Here we will choose the layout option in front of text as this is the most flexible option. Since the icon is a bit too big for the blue bar, we set the height to 0.7 cm and the width will automatically adapt to that size. Now we will insert a text box for the phone number, so we go to Insert, click on Text Box and select the first text box. From this box we remove the background color and also the outline. And then we can already enter our phone number. As you can see, the text is not perfectly vertically centered inside the text box. This is because Word automatically added space after the text. To remove that space, we go to the Home tab, open the line spacing options and click on Remove Space After Paragraph. Now we can already start to position the icon and the text box roughly relative to each other. Then we select both objects. Note that you need to hold down the Control key to select multiple objects at once. And when both objects are selected, we can align them perfectly by going to the Format tab, then hitting Align and then Align Middle. And to be able to move the two objects around as one item, we group them together. Now you can see that the outline is a bit long. This is because we didn't adapt the size of the text box. So we will simply do that now. Then let's duplicate the first contact information. For that we click in it and we will see two outlines. Since we want to duplicate the whole package, we have to select the outermost outline. And to now duplicate it, we hold down the Control key and drag the outline downwards. Since the duplicated item will contain our email, we have to change the icon by right-clicking on it, then selecting Change Graphic and afterwards From Icons. Now we type in Mail and insert the Mail icon. Of course, we also have to change the phone number to an email address and again adapt the size of the text box. And in my case, it happened that Word automatically capitalized the first letter. Since that does not look good, I move the cursor to that letter, then I move it downwards and open the autocorrect options. Here I can then undo the capitalization. Now we repeat the process of duplicating the contact item for the home address and the website. The next step is to position the contact items roughly on the blue bar. Then we change the fill color of the icons to a white color. And we do the same for the text color. And now we will align all contact items relative to each other. For that we first have to select all of them. And when we have to select multiple objects, it makes sense to activate the corresponding selection tool. So we click on Select and then on Select Objects. And now we can simply drag a rectangle over all our objects that we want to select. Afterwards we go to the second Format tab and align all objects vertically as we already did it before. To deactivate the object selection tool, we press the escape key and we are back in the normal mode again. But since we will now group all the contact items and also the blue bar, I will activate the object selection mode again, select all contact items, and manually add the blue bar by holding down the control key and clicking on its outline. Note that the blue bar didn't get selected with the other objects since the selection rectangle didn't fully cover it. So let's group all the items and the contact information bar is done. Now we will insert a text box for the name. Again we remove the fill color and the outline, and then we write our name in it. I'm going to change the size to 48 and adapt the width of the text box. And again I'm going to remove the space after the text. When we now want to position the text box at the top, we will notice that it can't be moved up there. This is because we have to change the layout options of the text box first. Let's choose in front of text again, as it is the most flexible one. And now we can move it up and reposition everything a bit. Then we will insert a bar for the date, and for that we select a shape with two rounded corners. To make the upper end perfectly round, we drag the orange point to the middle. Then we set a width of 1.1 cm and a height of 5.7 cm. Afterwards we change the background color to a gray color and remove the outline color. Now we rotate the bar by 90 degrees. And then we can already insert the text box for the date. We again remove the fill color and the outline. Then write in the date and remove the space at the bottom of the text box. After that, we resize the text box a bit and position it roughly on the gray bar. Then we again align both objects relative to each other, group them, and position the group at the right side of the page. Since the content text of the cover letter will start approximately 7 cm under the top border of the page, we have to change the top page margin. But before we do that, we first need to set a fixed position for all the objects that we created. So we click on the object, and in the layout options we select Fix Position on Page. If the button for the layout options doesn't appear, we can also access these options in the Format tab under Wrap Text. And now we can change the margin without moving all the objects that we created. So we go to Layout, click on Margins, and then on Custom Margins. Here we set a top margin of 7 cm. Then we write down the contact information of the company we are applying to. And since there is a lot of space between the lines, we select all but the last line and again remove the space after the paragraph. Now I'm going to paste a placeholder text which has a gray color and also a full justification alignment. Afterwards we duplicate the gray bar with its text and we rotate it by 180 degrees. Now we have to rotate the text box back and then we can already write our name in there. Note that we should position the text box in a way that it approximately aligns with the margin of the content text. And to make the design a bit more vivid, we insert a rectangular shape at the bottom. Make it 21 cm wide and 2.4 cm high. Afterwards, we position it at the bottom of the page and change the color to the one we used before. And that's it, now you created your own cover letter while also learning a lot about the tools in Word. Go ahead and watch the other videos to learn more about Microsoft Word.